going to put our pages on the put a piece of paper to cover up our inside covers. These are going to be cut at 7 3/4 by 7 3/4 because our covers are 8 by 8. So I just went ahead and used the same color that I used for my binding system and cut one, and I already applied this one down. So you're just going to put glue on it. All over, and we're going to line it up and apply it down just to cover up that inside chipboard and to kind of finish it off. Okay. And then our inside is finished. Now we need to work on our pages. So for our pages, I use the same color as I did for my chipboard, for my binding and for my inside covers. And we're going to make 6 pages for this album. And we're going to have a little bit different pages for each one. Not for each one, we're going to have a couple of different pages, and I'll walk you through each one. The first page is going to be a page that looks like this. This is where our hinge is going to go, and this is where our tag's going to go. And it will make more sense. You're going to have 3 of these. So I'm going to show you how to make one. So I'm going to put these to the side. So you're going to need to cut 3 of these at 7 1/2 by 7 1/2 to make 3 different pages for this album, okay? And then you're also going to need to cut 3 at 8 by 8, okay? So you need 3 cut at 7 1/2 by 7 1/2 and 3 cut at 8 by 8, okay? So we're going to set the 7 1/2 by 7 1/2 aside because we don't need it quite yet. We're going to take our score board out. And we're going to work on this one. And I already have it shown to you. On this side, we're going to score 1/2 inch. So, 1/2 inch on this side. And then we're going to flip it. And then on this side, we're going to score 1/2 inch. So you're going to have an L shape. Okay? Put your scoreboard away. You're going to do that to all 3 of the 8x8s. So take your 7 1/2, or take your 8x8 where you score, and you're going to take your scissors, and in this corner where you see that you scored, you're going to cut at an angle, if you see, and cut those off. And that's what it's going to look like. You need to do that to all 3 of the 8x8 that you scored 1/2 inch and 1/2 inch. And then you need your bone folder. You're going to take your score lines and fold them back, or fold them forward, or whatever you do, and reinforce them. Okay, we're going to apply glue to this side and to this flap. And you're going to do this for all 3 to get 3 of these pages. Okay. We're going to take our 7 1/2 by 7 1/2, and we're going to put it down on top, because essentially we made the other one underneath 7 1/2 by 7 1/2 by scoring and making the flaps. And this is how we're going to get a messy to get our opening for our hinge, and then an opening for our thing. So you're going to do 3 exactly like this. The next set of pages we're going to make are going to look like this. They're going to be open all through and closed on both sides. So what you're going to need to do, and we're going to have 2 of these. So you need to cut 2 pages at 7 1/2 by 7 1/2, and then you cut 2 at 7 1/2 by 8 1/2. Okay, guys? So we can put this one aside. We don't need the 7 1/2 and 7 1/2 right now. We're going to take our scoreboard back out. And we're going to do the long side. The 8 1/2 side is what the one you need to go this way. So it says 8 1/2. We're going to score at 1/2 inch and then at 8. So you have 2 score lines. 1/2 inch and 8. And this side is the 7 1/2 side, the one that you do not score on. Okay? Same thing. We're going to fold our score lines, reinforce them. for reinforce. So yet again, you need to cut two of these at 7.5 by 7.5, and then cut two at 7.5 by 8.5, and then you're going to score a 1/2 inch and 8 on the 8.5 inch side. Okay, so now what we're going to do is on our two flaps is apply glue. Not too much. I go overboard. That's why I get messy. And we're going to, again, put our 7.5 by 7.5. We're going to line them up. And apply it down. And you're going to do this to both of your pages that are going to be like this. So you have two that are open in the center. Okay, the third page is going to be a little bit different. I have a lot of questions on how I do these, so this is why I'm going to add this one in. These are going to be mini pages, kind of like envelopes. You can use envelopes for this, but I'm going to show you how to do it with cardstock. And we need to cut two of these that are 6 1/4 by 9. 6 1/4 by 9. We're going to have two of them, okay? So you're going to take it out, your scoreboard out, and we're going to score at 4 1/4 and then 8.5. Okay, guys? 4 1/4 by 8.5. We're going to take them and score. This is just going to be a little flap. A little flap. And fold over to make a little pocket. Okay, so we're just going to put our glue down on our little flap. And pull over. So now we have two of these. Two of these that are open like that. And then we have three of these that are going to be edge on the side, edge on the bottom, and open. Okay, guys? And that's going to be our pages. And the next step is going to start decorating our pages.